And Chris, this is MMA for you. I'm going to be doing my predictions for Bellator 154, Davis versus Lawal, which happens on May 14th. But before I get into that, I'd like to plug my own author's website at www.chrismaldong.com. I am an aspiring author specializing in the fantasy genre, and you can support my journey of being an author by buying my first novel, an action adventure. Fancy action adventure called The Mustard Prince in the Condiment Kingdom for $8.95 at www.chrismaldong.com. Also, on my website, you can check out blogs which are updated weekly, free short stories, other short story collections for sale, and a Writer's Talk web series, which is just me talking everything writing. Okay, on to this card. I'm really surprised that this is actually on the same night that UFC 198 is on. This is a good card, actually. Awad versus Santos is cool. Piccolotti is a good prospect. Ray Wood's actually pretty solid, too. I watched one of his fights. I like his stand-up game. Andre Fialho is a really fun action fighter. But Rick Reger, he's not too bad. I actually liked his wrestling and like ground and pound game. Wrestling and grappling game, actually. Ground and pound and grappling. Davis versus King Mo is a really interesting matchup. I don't know if it'll be a fun fight, but it's an interesting fight. The prelims, you have like UFC veteran Darren Uyenoyama. Stephanie Frausto, the sister of Zwala Frausto. So, a couple prospects here. Looks like there's an Andres Alcantar, who's like 3-0, trains out of MMA Lab. Guys with actual pretty good records. Josh San Diego is 6-1. Josh Paiva, 7-1, 25 years old. Danisabe, Muhammed, 4-0. So, Martin Sano, 4-1, with a 24 years old. So, decent prospects. I will say I've seen some of these people, like Josh San Diego, Darren Uyenoyama, Stephanie Frausto, Thomas Diagne, Mark Dickman. Otherwise, a lot of these people, I just haven't seen their fights. I probably actually should. But I'm kind of doing this so many times I have to really do this show. So, I did watch all the I have seen fights from all the main card fighters, though. So, let's get started. In the main event, we have Mr. Wonderful, Phil Davis versus King Mo, Muhammed King Mo Lawal. Okay, King Mo, 19-4 record with 1-0 contest, 13 wins by KO or TKO, 6 wins by decision. He also has 2 losses by KO or TKO. 35 years old, he's 6 foot, on a 7-fight win streak, training out of ATT. He's a former Strikeforce light heavyweight champion. Most recently, he won a Risen Grand Prix. He's a strong wrestler. Chains his takedowns really well. His ground and pound, once he gets it to the ground, is really good too. He has finished opponents from with his ground and pound. His boxing is actually pretty solid. Defensively, could still use some work, but offensively isn't too bad. He is pretty heavy-handed though. He has knocked down and or knocked out opponents with his hands. Phil Davis, 15-3 record with 1-0 contest, 3 wins by KO or TKO, 5 wins by sub, 31 years old, he's 6-2 on a 2-fight win streak. He trains out of Alliance. He's also a strong wrestler. If he can really get in on the hips, he generally will take you down. He's really good in a ride position. That's how he used that, especially against Glover Teixeira. Among other opponents. His Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu game is actually pretty solid too. He has a really good Kimura. Used that against Newton And I use that in the UFC as well. I've got a variation of that on Tim Boesch, along with a really good front choke series as well. His stand-up is average, I'd say. He uses a lot of movement, a lot of wasted movement, but movement nonetheless. He's actually not bad defensively. He survived 3 rounds with Anthony Rumble Johnson. He's a guy that is relatively good at not getting hit too much and too hard. His stand-up, it is improving. He did knock out Carmon in his last fight. But it still has that awkwardness to it. I would definitely say that Lawal, well, not definitely say, but, well, yeah, definitely say that Lawal's the harder hitter of the two. I think Lawal has the capability of winning this by either decision or KO or TKO, whereas Phil Davis cannot see a sub. I think he'd have a hard enough time taking Lawal down. So if Davis wins, it's probably by decision. And that's what I'm going with, Phil Davis by decision. Phil Davis, for all his faults, he still needs some work in the stand-up. I always mention this to a friend I watch fights with. When we watch Phil Davis fights, it's always the same thing. It's like, he's thinking too much. You know, it's like, it's not muscle memory with him yet. It's like, he's still very stiff. He's still really stiff as a striker. I actually don't think the alliance style of striking really fits him very well. I think it's helped him defensively enough. Like I said, this is a guy that doesn't really get dropped too much. He's not a guy that you see get hit hard too much, you know. So the movement has helped him in that sense. But as far as offense goes, like, it doesn't seem to fit him well. I think Davis is a naturally better kicker, though, than he is a puncher. That's another thing, too, where King Mo is primarily a puncher. This should be close, though, because both guys are, like, essentially wrestle boxers, you know. And while Lawal does have more power in his strikes, Davis, like I said, he's not a guy that generally gets hit clean and hard and dropped very often, you know. So I think that Phil Davis, at bat, I think he just outpoint King Mo. More so than anything, it's being his bicycle. Make it seem like he's doing more than he probably really is. You know, strike from the outside, kick from the outside too. That actually, it was kicks from the outside, like what Newton did. Was quite effective on King Mo as far as just scoring points and making it hard for King Mo to land punches. I can see Phil Davis using his kicks in that sense. So yeah, Phil Davis by decision. Next fight of that, Andre Fialho fights Rick Boomer Reger. Or is it Reger? I think it's Reger. I'll say Reger. Rick Reger, 7-1 record, 2 wins by KO or TKO, 4 wins by sub, 29 years old, he's 5'10". I saw one fight of his and a highlight video of his. He has some pretty good wrestling. This guy slams dudes when he takes them down. I thought his ground and pound actually pretty good, and his overall grappling game wasn't too bad. His stand-up, though, I didn't see too much of it. It looked average at best. I mean, like, his boxing wasn't too bad. But, you know, I just didn't see enough of it. And even the highlight video I saw of it was him slamming dudes to the mat. And the one fight I saw of his was him slamming a dude to the mat. And, getting a sub. I think he's rear naked. Andre Fialho, 6-0, undefeated record. 5 wins by KO/TKO, 1 win by sub. 22 years old. He's 6 foot. According to Sherdog, he's training out of AKA right now. He's never been past the second round. His stand-up's good. He's pretty heavy-handed. He actually uses combinations quite well. I think he won his last fight with a... he had a really good combination. I was like, a hook straight or straight hook. I forgot what it was. It was a really nice combination punching. This is interesting because they put Fialho high up on this card. This is only his second fight in Bellator, I think, if I'm not mistaken. He was on the prelims last time out and got the knockout. He's still young. He's still very inexperienced, but, you know, there's red flags here. He's never passed the second round. I don't know how he's going to fare against a guy that just wants to take him down all day. Training at AKA, though, should help him with his wrestling. And then he's already a really strong striker as well. And, you know, I'll say this about Bellator and World Series of Fighting. Usually, they match up a lot of guys favorably. I mean, that's just the way it is. They don't have a big enough roster to have, like, really even matchups, you know, or really, it's either, like, one guy's a hot prospect versus who's this guy. That's kind of what's happening here. So, I mean, it's hard to pick against, in Bellator and World Series of Fighting, it's actually really hard to pick against favorites because of the way they, when you get an idea of how they book fighters. So, yeah, nonetheless, I gotta go with Andre Fialho to win this one by KO or TKO. Stand-up game's good. I don't know much about his grappling. There's a red flag in the fact that he's never been past the second round. I think he's only been to the second round once. I do like he's still young. If he's training at AKA, I like that he's training at one of the bigger camps. So that's all positive. So Andre Fialho by KO or TKO. Next fight after that, Adam Piccolotti fights Ray All Business Wood. Ray Wood, 7-1 record, 4 wins by KO or TKO, 2 wins by sub. He's 5-8 on a 2-fight win streak. I saw one fight of his, and I actually liked his game pretty well. He showed a good Muay Thai game. And he used combinations too, like 2-punch combo to a kick. He used a spinning wheel kick. He did a couple flying knees on his opponent. He actually won his fight with a knee. And then fall ground and pound. The fight I saw, I forgot against the guy's name. I did not, however, get to see anything of his ground game. So I cannot speak about it, unfortunately. Adam Piccolotti, 7-0 undefeated record. 2 wins by KO TKO. 3 wins by sub. 27 years old. He's 5'11". So I was watching video of his before he fought that one guy from Team Alpha Male. In his last fight in Bellator. So, and then I saw that fight. I like his Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu game. It is real strong. And in MMA. And he has really good back control too. He's good at taking the back. Finding the back. Keeping back control as well. And he also showed some improved stand-up in his last fight too. So I liked what I saw there. Overall, I just like Piccolotti's overall game better. I gotta say, Ray Wood, like I said, his striking game looked pretty solid. I actually liked his striking game. I thought it was pretty good. But Piccolotti, with his ground, with his ground game, submission ability, and improving stand-up, I gotta go Adam Piccolotti to win this by submission. Wouldn't surprise me if he takes it back and gets a choke. Next fight after that, actually tough one for me to call, as Saad, Assassin Awad fights Evangelista Cyborg Santos. Santos, 21-16 record, 12 wins by KO TKO, 6 wins by sub. Has 10 losses by KO TKO, 2 losses by sub. 38 years old, he's 5'10 on a 2-fight win streak. Trains at a Shooto Box. I think it's his own Shooto Box, like, gym, if I'm not mistaken. He's good Muay Thai. Real heavy-handed guy, and has shown his last fight against Brennan Ward. He's a threat on the ground if you give him the opportunity. Got that leg lock, submitted Ward. However, it has to be said, this guy's chin is deteriorating. You don't, 16 losses, 10 of them are by KO or TKO, you know. Saad Awad, 18-7 record, 7 wins by KO or TKO, 7 wins by sub. Has his 2 losses by KO or TKO and 2 losses by sub. 32 years old, he's 5'10", trains out of Millennia MMA with the likes of Lorenz Larkin. A one stand-up's good. He's particularly heavy-handed. He's still the only guy who's beaten Will Brooks. His grappling, it's there. You know, he has offensive takedown ability. He has takedown defense. He can get a submission. So, like, it's there. It's probably not his strength, but it is something that he does have. This is interesting because, one, I don't know what weight class this is at. Santos, I know Brendan Ward and Santos was at welterweight. Syed Awad fights at lightweight. So this is interesting just from a weight perspective. Santos should be the bigger guy. They're the same height though. So I don't know if someone who's going up, who's going down, or what's going on there. Admittedly, I should have probably checked that out. It's actually really hard to find sometimes, but I could just gone to the website and found out maybe. I'm gonna be honest, it's just hard to trust Santos to win against a guy who has heavy punches. I mean, anyone that's like heavy-handed, I'm gonna be very hesitant to pick Santos to beat just because his chin isn't what it used to be. Defensively, both these guys aren't the greatest. I've seen Syed Awad get dropped before. Fought that one dude from Guam and just gets dropped in like the first like second, first couple seconds, for example, But Awad didn't like have a bad chin. He also got knocked out by Rickles as well, though. So it's not impenetrable either. But nonetheless, like I said, it's hard to trust Evangelista Santos against another heavy hitter. So I'm gonna go Syed Awad by KO or TKO, but tough one to call because Santos looks like a guy that could prove me wrong. I don't know how the weight's gonna go. Santos might should very well be the bigger fighter here. So yeah, interesting fight nonetheless, but I'll go Syed Awad, KO or TKO. Okay, the undercard. We have Thomas Diagne versus Mark Tricky Dickman. Okay, Diagne, 5-5 record with one draw, 4 wins by KO or TKO, 1 win by decision. It's 2 losses by KO or TKO, 2 losses by sub. He's 6-1 and trains out of AKA. Mark Dickman, 10-2 record, 6 wins by KO or TKO, 3 wins by sub, 31 years old, and he's 5'9". I'll go with Mark Dickman to win that one. And next fight of that, Joshua Hardwick fights Jorge Acosta. I'll just say it right now. Have not watched any videos of these guys. Hardwick, no pro MMA bouts. 0-1 as amateur. With that 1 loss by sub, he's 20 years old. However, he does train out of Elevation Fight Team with the likes of Dillashaw, Tony Sims, Brandon Thatch, among others. Jorge Acosta, 0-1 record with that 1 loss by TKO. I'll go with Joshua Hardwick to win that one. Next fight off that, Victor Jones fights Anthony Taylor. Once again, have not seen any video of these guys. Can't say anything about them except for the records. Anthony Taylor, 0-1 record with that 1 loss by sub. He's 1-6 as an amateur, and he's 5'7". Victor Jones, 0-1, pro record with that 1 loss by decision, but he does train out of AKA. I'll go with Victor Jones to win that one. Next fight that, Danisabe Muhammed fights Martin Sano. Made a big mistake here. I should have actually watched a video of these guys because record-wise, they actually look pretty interesting. 4-1, 24 years old against a guy who's 4-0. Big mistake on my part. After this, I'll probably try and get some video of them, or want some video of them. So, Danisabe Muhammad, 4-0, undefeated record, 3 wins by sub, 1 win by decision. Martin Sano, 4-1 record, 1 win by TKO, 3 wins by sub, 24 years old. He's 5'11". He is a finisher, and he last fought in December of 2014. I'll go with Danisalvi Muhammad to win that one. Next fight is that. Josh Paiva fights Steven Gruber. You know what? I've actually seen Paiva. I just don't remember anything of him. Don't know any. Haven't watched any video of Gruber. If I'm not mistaken, this fight's at 125 pounds. Height difference is quite substantial here. Steven Gruber has a 5-2 record. One win by KO, three wins by sub, and two losses by KO or TKO. He's 5 foot. Josh Paiva, 7-1 record. Two wins by KO or TKO, four wins by sub. 25 years old. He's 5'6 on a 3-fight win streak. I'll go Josh Paiva to win that one. Next fight after that, Sam Spengler fights Doyle Childs. I have not watched any video of these guys. So, Sam Spengler, 8-5 record, 3 wins by KO TKO, 1 win by sub, has us 2 losses by KO TKO, 2 losses by sub, and he's 5-11 on a 3-5 win streak. Doyle Childs, 2-1 record, 1 win by TKO, 1 win by sub, he also has 1 loss by KO, he's a finisher, he's never been to decision. I'll go with Sam Spengler to win that one. Next fight after that, Josh San Diego fights Jeremiah Labiano. Labiano, 9-4 record, 3 wins by KO TKO, 4 wins by sub, says 2 losses by KO TKO. He's 5'10", and he's trading wins and losses. Josh San Diego, 6-1 record, 1 win by KO, 3 wins by sub, and he's 5'10". I remember seeing some of his fights. If I'm not mistaken, like, his striking wasn't entirely powerful. His grappling looked pretty good, though. Nonetheless, I'll go Josh San Diego to win that one. Next fight of that. Alvin Cacdac fights Darren B.C. Uyenoyama. Alvin Cacdac, 16-12 record, 7 wins by KO TKO, 7 wins by sub. Says 2 losses by KO TKO, 8 losses by sub. He's 5-6, and he's trading losses and wins. Uyenoyama, 10-5 record, 2 wins by KO TKO, 4 wins by sub, 36 years old. He's 5-6 on a 2-fight win streak, and he is a UFC veteran. He's actually a pretty, he has a pretty sneaky takedown game, and a really sneaky ground game, too. Stand-up isn't anything great. It's actually really not that, you know, average at best, you know? But his grappling is really strong. With that said, I think Darren Uyenoyama wins this by submission. Next fight is that. Stephanie Makakina Frausto fights Jaimee Lean Nievara. I know nothing about Nievara, and she has no pro MMA bouts. Haven't seen any amateur bouts either. Frausto, 5-5 record, 2 wins by KO TKO, 3 wins by sub, says it's 2 losses by submission. 25 years old, she's 5'2", and trains out of Combat Sports Academy. The likes of Miriam Nakamoto, Elena Maxwell, Zoala Frausto, I think, trains there now. Frausto, stand-up's not that, yeah, it's not that great. I don't know what weight class this fight is contested at. I've seen Frausto, if I'm not mistaken, she fought as low as 105. Her grappling game is actually pretty good. I mean, she has been out-grappled, but I thought she's not too bad there. Nonetheless, I'll go with Stephanie Frausto to win that one, probably by sub. Next fight after that, Andres Alcantar fights Nick Pica. Once again, I made a mistake. Two guys are undefeated. One of them out of MMA Lab. And I hate to say, I haven't watched videos of these guys, and I definitely should have. Nick Pica, 5-0 undefeated record, 2 wins by KO TKO, 2 wins by sub, he's 5'10". Alcantar, 3-0 undefeated record, 2 wins by KO TKO, 1 win by decision, he's 5'11", trains out of MMA Lab. I'll go with Andres Alcantar to win that one. And finally, James Chapman fights Sean Tucker. Chapman, according to Sherdog, he has no pro or amateur bouts. Sean Tucker, 0-1 as a pro, with that one loss by TKO. I think it's a first round TKO, if I'm not mistaken. And his amateur record is 0-2 with both his losses by TKO, also in the first round. 27 years old, and he's 6'2". It's not something I'd really like to see, even though I know not. I know Chapman has, like, no problem with MMA bouts. I mean, a guy who keeps losing by TKO, it's not a great look, so I gotta go with James Chapman to win that one. Okay, to recap. In the main card, I have Phil Davis over Muhammed Lawal by decision. Andre Fialho beating Rick Reger by KO TKO. Adam Piccolotti over Ray Wood by submission. And Saad Awad over Evangelista Santos by KO TKO. On the undercard, I have Mark Dickman over Thomas Diagne. Joshua Hardwick beating Jorge Acosta. Victor Jones over Anthony Taylor. Danisabe Muhammad beating Martin Sano. Josh Paiva beating Steven Gruber. Sam Spengler over Doyle Childs. Josh San Diego beating Jeremiah Labiano. Darren Uyenoyama over Alvin Cacdac. Stephanie Frausto over Jaimee Nievara. Andres Alcantar beating Nick Pica. James Chapman beating Sean Tucker. So that's it for my Bellator 154 predictions. If you have any comments, just leave them below. And please buy the Mustard Prince in the Condiment Kingdom for $8.95 at www.chrismaldong.com. So that's it for MMA for you. Thank you guys very much.